For the most part, dead man brakes are normally on the rigid casters, not the swivel casters. And as you can see, a dead man brake is always engaged. There's a mechanism, spring mechanism on the inside, which keeps the caster from not moving at all times when it's on the cart. And this flange, and there is a left side and a right side. They are not interchangeable because you want to have the flange on the outside. So if our cart, we're facing this way, you're going to have a left and you're going to have a right, okay? And you need to have a handle so when you engage it, so you have motorcycle brakes, aerospace brakes, whatever sort of brake cables that you want to use that actually attach to this flange, okay? So when this flange gets pulled, that's what allows you to disengage the brake that's attached to the actual hub, the drum right here. A drum brake is like a bicycle brake. So if we were to squeeze the handle on a drum brake, it would do the exact opposite. It would apply pressure like a bicycle brake and allow you to slowly slow the car down instead of automatically stopping it. Going up and down ramps, if I was going down a ramp and I slipped, it would automatically stop. Or more importantly, if I were pushing it up a ramp and I slipped, it wouldn't come back crashing down on me and run me over, okay? Or you are in the arts world and you have a lot of stage props that don't need to move. They stick in one spot. It's a big standard in that sort of industry. So. Just to reiterate, to summarize, when we're using a dead man brake system, we are talking about individuals that are going up ramps, down ramps, so if it slips, it stops dead in its tracks, doesn't go flying down a ramp, loose, run someone over, or if I'm going up a ramp, it doesn't come back on me. Dead man brake on the rigid casters. Okay, now we have our cables here. So that is on the end user, you as the client, to supply these. Now you will see, and this is very, very, very important, where you attach the cables to where you attach to the actual flange is very, very important, okay? The optimal distance on where the brake lines connect to the flange is no longer than 1.5, 2 inches. That is optimal distance because when you're squeezing the handles up top, you want that to be no more than 30 newtons of force, okay? That is, it shouldn't be harder to squeeze the handle than it actually is to push your car. The further away you put this point, the harder it's gonna be to disengage your dead man rigid casters, okay? This is probably one of the most important things is where you attach. And you definitely wanna make sure you have quality cables, otherwise they could snap. We've witnessed that in the field. That is very important. So you wanna make sure you've got your length properly measured. You know, here they drilled holes in and they fed the cables up through the handle. You might not be able to do that, so you got a plan on how to have where you're gonna keep your cables, where they're gonna go, how are you gonna put handles on it? Are you gonna design a piece of steel, bicycle, motorcycle handles? You need to figure that sort of stuff out. You know, we can help maybe guide you on that, but we do not provide those sort of things. That's the sort of stuff that you need to be able to understand when purchasing this system, okay? Thanks for listening. We hope this was beneficial when it comes to understanding when and how to use dead man brake systems. Please head to casterconnection.com, go in the search bar and type in dead man, and you'll find out all the information you need. See you again next time.